Saxenda for weight loss, and are the Ozempic and Wegovy shortages coming to an end soon so that diabetics can finally get their hands on their medicine again and that obesity won't be to blame? In this video, we will do a deep dive on Saxenda or liraglutide since you guys have all been asking me for it. Also, let me know down below if you're coming back here from the Ozempic for weight loss without diabetes video I made that a lot of you seem to enjoy. I'd love to connect with you down in the comments below. Now, without wasting any more time, I left the timestamps down below too, so let's get started. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions when it comes to your health and wellness, and I'd love for you all to gently tap on that like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Saxenda is the brand name for liraglutide, and in 2010, the FDA approved a liraglutide-containing medicine known as victoza, which some of you may be aware of, to help type 2 diabetics get a better grip over their sugar levels. But guess what? A similar story happened with Ozempic and Wegovy. And what do you know? Researchers found that some people who lost weight while taking it, so they then explored if non-diabetics who were obese could benefit from it too. Sure enough, 4 years later, Saxenda was born, which was a higher strength version of liraglutide, FDA approved for chronic weight management. There are rules to this though. Not everyone who wants to get slim can get prescribed it. Now the rules might not all be followed, but in a perfect world, your doctor will have it prescribed if you meet the following criteria: a BMI of 30 or more, which is obese, 27 or more, which is overweight, but you must also have at least one other weight-related comorbid condition, like having high blood pressure or trouble managing cholesterol. In 2020, however, they expanded its approval to include adolescents 12 years or older who also had a BMI of 30 or more or weighed at least 132 pounds, which in America, this makes sense, right? Because childhood obesity and diabetes rates are climbing through the roofs here, which is quite unfortunate. And a lot like Ozempic and Wegovy, Saxenda also belongs to the same class of medicines known as GLP-1 agonists, which mimic your natural GLP-1 hormones to help you not only regulate your appetite, but also slow down how fast food leaves your stomach, which makes you feel full longer and causes you to consume less calories. Which can explain those tummy aches you get with this class of medicine, since the food actually stays in the stomach longer. The main difference between the two are that instead of once a week injections, Saxenda is given as a once a day injection in a multi-dose injection pen that can deliver 5 different doses ranging from 0.6 milligrams, which will be your starting dose, all the way to 3 milligrams, which will be your maintenance and target dose. Also, since you'll be using the pen more than once, you want to make sure you get separate needles that attach to the pen before each use and a new pen needle for every injection daily with or without food, which your pharmacist should have gone over. And side effects seem to be a big one that is searched for these medicines. I found a good chart that compares what most people experience to Saxenda's sister, Wegovy, and it seems that people complain less with Saxenda. You get less nausea and less abdominal pain. But keep in mind, everyone will experience the side effects differently. And if you look at the studies, my favorite one here in the New England Journal of Medicine that followed 3,731 patients over 56 weeks found the most frequently reported side effects were mild or moderate nausea and diarrhea, who ended up losing an average of 8% of their initial body weight, which may explain why you may have an easier time to find Saxenda. Since no one really wants an 8% loss, they want the 14.9% weight loss they can get with semaglutide. In fact, if I search on the FDA shortage database for liraglutide, nothing pops up, but if I type in semaglutide, you can see clearly that Ozempic and Wegovy are still in shortages. And I've had a number of you all comment below how frustrating this situation was and how it's painful to go through, and I do get it. And it's not just Novo Nordisk, the manufacturer behind Ozempic and Saxenda. It's even Eli Lilly's Mounjaro that seems to have been affected as well. And I personally attribute this back to this thing here. It's insane that you can be one hashtag away from a complete shortage of dire and life-saving medication. But that's for another discussion, right? Moving along, when it comes to the cost, GLP-1 agonists are not cheap here in the US. Some of you commented down below how affordable these medicines are in your country. It's not the same case here in the US. Some reports show us that medicines can be as much as 4 times higher here than other countries. If we pull up GoodRx on our GLP-1s, we can see that from the cheapest to the most expensive, it goes from Trulicity to Ozempic, then it's Saxenda as low as $1,300. On a serious note, what I really wanted to address here is the question, are overweight and obese people the cause of this shortage? Are they really to be blamed for this? Now, this is just my opinion, but I do believe that there is a huge overlap between diabetes and obesity. People who have obesity have a high risk of eventually developing diabetes. And while it is easy to say we should save this medication for the people who really need it, and I completely understand that, we also need to look at obesity as its own disease that is equally deserving of treatment. But, and hear me out on this, it should not be at the expense of diabetics. And can you really blame the manufacturer too? Let me know if you think the manufacturer is to blame in the comments, but the CEO of Novo Nordisk did say, quote, had we forecasted that, we would have built a different supply chain. Now, what about any good news, Dr. Arslan? Is there any good news? Please tell me the shortage will end soon. Well, what I can tell you from the manufacturer that if you're in the US, all dose strengths of Wegovy are now available in retail pharmacies nationwide. And if you wanted to bring this up with your doctor, now might be a good time to have that discussion to see if your insurance will cover you. Now, I really can't stress the importance of lifestyle changes that need to happen while you wait for your medicine or while you are on it currently. If you made a goal of yours to lose weight this year as a New Year's resolution, take this video as a reminder that you should not underestimate what I call baby steps. It's really easy to see someone else's success story with their weight loss and get overwhelmed with how you may not be quite there yet. You can't be fixated on that. Focus on your day-to-day choices and take small steps and forget the big and drastic steps that are way too hard to commit to. Instead, try examples like eating from smaller plates, parking farther away from the grocery store entrance to walk a little more, using chopsticks to help you eat slower, taking a 15-minute walk every now and then, and practice more mindful eating where you are not distracted. And remember, every time you say no to an unhealthy behavior, you're saying yes towards the next baby step that'll ultimately take you to the finish line, which I know you will achieve. If you haven't watched the Ozempic video yet, where I leave an amazing bonus tip at the end, you can watch it right here and let me know what your thoughts are. Click the red subscribe button down below too if you found any value, and I'll see you on the next one.